Frost, if you will, is the poet. If you will, you can call him a philosopher poet. Trump is a statesman, a leader. If you don't like the dignity of that term, a politician. But this distinction is of critical importance because, and this may not be very obvious when you're on campus, but it's very obvious when you're out in the world, at some point, the necessary skepticism of thought has to give way to the necessary dogmatism of action. And what I mean by that is that at some point, it's not enough to say, on the one hand and on the other hand, something there is that doesn't love a wall. Good fences make good neighbors. Well, are you going to build the damn thing or no? At some point, you got to go. You got to decide. You've got to move. You got to take a decision. And if you decide not to do it, that's your decision. And so Trump is out there making a case for the wall. And yet on the face of it, his case is manifestly inadequate. Trump says, we need to have a wall for three reasons. One, drug traffickers. Two, violent criminals. And three, sex traffickers. We have to stop, in other words, the bad guy. Now that argument by itself may be true or may not be true, but is clearly insufficient. Because a wall may stop those people, but it would certainly stop a whole lot of other people too. Let's call them the good guys, people who just want to come here for a better life for themselves and their families, and a wall would clearly do that too. So the real case for the wall can't just talk about the bad guys, it also has to consider the case for stopping some good guys. On the other side of the debate, you've got all the people who say that Trump hates immigrants. Now, this argument that Trump hates immigrants relies on making a very squid-like confusion between the immigrant and the illegal. Notice the people say, whoa, illegal immigrants. Illegals are not actually immigrants. Illegals are people who essentially want to jump the line. There is a big line, and there are some people, and I would put myself in this category, who were born a very long ways away from America. Quite frankly, we don't have a Rio Grande that we can come thrashing across or a ditch that we can tunnel under to get to America. We actually have to get here by a very circuitous and lengthy route. It costs a lot of money, it costs a lot of tears, and sometimes it takes a generation. And yet, why does our welfare count less than somebody who happens to be just across the border, who basically says, I don't care about this line. I'm going to jump it. And because I am a tragic humanitarian figure, I'm going to rely on the goodwill of the other side, the people on the other side of the line, to sacrifice not them, but Dinesh, who's too far away to get here this way, and I'm going to do that in the name of humanity.